What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name's Damon Warren, and this is Day One Tech. This is where I share my tech experiences to help you find out if a piece of technology is good for you or maybe not so good. Today, we're going to be talking about the Google Pixel 7 and why I like this phone. The Pixel 7. Does it have the best camera? No. Does it have the best forward-facing camera? The selfie camera? No. The screen? Is it the best screen? No. Why I like the Pixel 7 is software. It reminds me that a phone is a communication device. And as far as a communication device, this is it. This is the best communication device out there right now. But when I say communication advice, I mean as far as being able to communicate with people, not just calling somebody, FaceTime or Google Meets with a video, email. This allows me to also communicate with people that don't speak English, don't speak my language. Go to visit websites that don't have English translation or you get stuck on it. This phone does a lot. Translates websites, takes the text, has a thing called Lens, which you can take a picture of something and it will try to find other pictures of it on the internet. Let's say you're visually impaired, like me without my glasses, it's a little hard for me to see different things. It now has a guided selfie. So once you activate it, it will tell me left, right, and I don't have to put my glasses on, take them off, put them on, take them off. So it has the voice assistance for that, which is great. Also on the communication side, they're gonna be offering a VPN. Basically what a VPN is a private network. So it secures your phone and the information that your phone sends out and receives. And that's gonna be coming soon and that's gonna be free. And as far as software, the things that I really like about Android software, and I don't go back and forth with who's better. I say it like this. There are different tools for different jobs. Really depends on what you're looking for a phone to do, right? If you're a photographer and you really like the good pictures and the video and being able to move it around, and you might be a content creator and doing different things, then I definitely say iOS. I definitely say, because in all those realms, it does it. But if you're looking for a phone, a communication device that you can walk around with, It has accessibility built into it. It's intuitive. If you think about something, you can just do it on Android, which makes it a lot easier. Like little things like moving the icons. You can just move them anywhere you want. You just move it, right? And if you don't like it, you just drag it to the top and it disappears. That makes it real easy. Everything's real fluid as far as the software on this phone. The other thing that it does with the software is the way that it processes the picture. Now, this camera is not the best camera, but the software with this camera makes it a very big contender. I've taken pictures, I'll show them up on the screen. Nice shot. Handheld, I was at a friend of mine's wedding, and I just saw this boat, this gazebo out over the water, and I could barely see the stars. And I took the picture with the phone, and I was amazed. That is the thing that this phone does with software. It takes the picture, and then through the processing, it does different things with it. So it's almost like you take the picture, and then I get excited to see how the phone is gonna, I'm gonna see how the phone translates what it's seeing, and then it spits it out to me. Then it goes a little, they're still working on some bugs, because in the video, there were some points where it was very vibrant, and then I panned, And it adjusted the color and it dropped everything out. And I'm sure that's something they can fix in software, but that's one of the things that I didn't like. But as far as in the software, boom, pictures are nice. I did some long exposures, right? These are all handheld, no tripods. I just pull out the phone, took the picture. Speaking of taking a picture, ease of use. Android phones, they've had it for a while, but if you double tap your power button that's on the side here, it goes right into the camera. That's it. You grab it in, you got it, You see something, you pull out, double tap, there's your camera. I don't even have to think about it. I know where my camera is. And let's say I want to do a selfie. I got some people with me. I got like somebody on my other side and I want to do a selfie. You twist it and there's your selfie camera, right? And you twist it again and then it's back to normal. Double tap on the power button, goes back into lock. That is the ease of use that I'm talking about. I'm talking about this kind of ease of use where the phone, the communication device becomes an extension of me. I don't have to think about what I'm about to do. I just can do it. I like that. It also has, when I say accessibility, a lot of cameras, other cameras, they balance them based on people's complexions and they don't account for a myriad of different complexions. And somebody like me with a dark background, a lot of cameras have a hard time bringing up the shadows. This does it because in the software, it starts to recognize the person that's taking the most pictures and then it knows to adjust for that automatically in the software. AI, right? That's what it does. It starts doing that. And then when you take the pictures, they come out a lot better because it's balancing it out based on who's usually in the pictures. And I'm just really amazed. It's really becoming a lot more fun using this to take the pictures, especially for something like social media. Now, the problem that I'm having or the thing that slows me down is getting it from here to someplace else. Let's say I'm using my MacBook. There's no clear way to transfer from here to a MacBook. So what I have to do, and I had to do this before, I have to upload it to Google Drive and then on my MacBook download it. Does it take a long time? Not too long, but it slows down the process. I can't just like AirDrop like I did with my iPhone. I just flick it over. Or I just hook a cord into my iPad and transfer the files and come back and everything's done. So there's that. But if you're looking for a phone that is an extension of you, allows you to customize it to the things you like, I would definitely say the Pixel 7. And the price. The price is really good, right? You're guaranteed 3 years of all the software updates, everything that Google's gonna come out with. You're getting all the software updates and it comes in at about $599. So that's why I like this phone. I've been using it daily, just carrying it around with me, recording some things. I'm not completely convinced about the video. There's a couple programs that I can't use on it yet. So that part's still being worked out because it's still new. But for pictures, communication, it's amazing. So it has a lot of promise and it all depends on what you're going to use it for. So if you have any questions, you know, what kind of phone are you using? You using Android, are you using iOS? Let me know. And I really do appreciate everybody watching this video, subscribing, you know, give me little tips and pointers, let me know what's going on. Appreciate you. Until next time, remember, take care of each other. Peace out. And I'll see you all soon.